These gulls are the inspiration for the name of the islands of Chile's lake region. In the Mapuche language, they are called Chueyes, and the home of the Chueyes is called Chiloé, a place marked by the passage of wind and rain. In addition to its varied fauna, the Chiloé archipelago is increasingly recognized for its wooden churches, places of worship that since the mid-18th century have welcomed visitors crossing the Chacao Channel. More than 40 churches are scattered along the archipelago. Their structural characteristics represent an architectural style that is unique in the world. The extreme weather conditions that affect this living heritage have posed the challenge of their conservation, preservation, and restoration.
La restauración de la iglesia se realiza en base a una metodología sustentada por criterios.
The churches are restored using a method based on maintaining the architectural style and construction technique. We do the restoration based on what is here. In other words, we don't intend to change the way they were originally built.
Cambiar el sistema con que fueron construidos originalmente.
Respecting what has always been there, Fundación Amigos de las Iglesias de Chiloé has embarked on a project to restore 16 of these churches, a one-of-a-kind project that involves the people, their stories, and customs. They have come to know the fine woods and thus their own heritage.
If these churches were not restored like this, the community would have a hard time doing it on their own. I thought the churches were going to fall down. And if one falls, it could never be restored to its former glory.
Today, Chiloé has changed. Restoring these churches is vitally important to the local population, which sees cultural tourism as an opportunity for development.
Our special development plans are often focused on infrastructure, but the people want work and jobs, and the churches are the capital they can use to expand the tourism industry in their own unique, warm, local island way, based on something as crucial to their identity as these churches.
And it is this Chilotan identity that is setting the stage for this restoration project. The contributions of the local population, which has a long tradition of community work, known in Chile as Minga, are renewing more than just these churches.
It is more than just a religious issue. One of the core objectives of the restoration process here in the foundation is specifically this renewed awareness of understanding of the value surrounding this heritage. And whenever the restoration process reaches a milestone, the community takes pride in what they've preserved. You know, it's more than the plants, the wood, or the good work. It's their culture.
For the IDB, a partner in this initiative, contributing to the development of the heritage of different peoples has countless social benefits over the medium and long terms.
It has a dual meaning. There is a financial significance, but there is also a much deeper meaning. A region's cultural, religious heritage, as well as its traditions, can contribute to its economic and social development.
The project's completion in 2008 will mean more than just the recovery of the Chiloé Church's architectural splendor. It will mark the beginning of sustainable development in the region with a renewed pride in its cultural heritage.